my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you guys a highlighting and low lighting technique that helps you blend gray hair. So stay tuned. Channel. I am so excited to be sharing this video with you guys. A lot of you had asked me how I highlight, how I low light, and how to kind of blend some gray hair into my clients. So my client today is actually my mom. She is so awesome. She has probably about 75% gray hair, but she still wants to look young and fun, and so we actually blend in her gray hair with this special technique, and it is amazing for those clients who want to blend their gray, kind of disguise it without having to cover it or without having a lot of maintenance. Now, my mom does come in every 6 to 7 weeks, but that's just because she really likes getting her hair done and because she gets to see me, right? But the great thing is, she actually doesn't have to come in every 6 to 7 weeks. She could probably go 8 to even 10 weeks because this technique actually grows out super nicely. It grows out really subtly, and you guys will see that in her before. It's been about 7 weeks since she did her hair, but it's still really beautiful. It's blended really nicely. It doesn't have a line of demarcation, and that is crucial. And this technique is gonna be one that really sets you apart from other stylists. So I'm gonna share with you guys how to do it, so let's get started.
All right, so this is our before. You guys can see she's got some natural gray in there, and we are going to blend it out. This is about 7 weeks growth for her, but the best thing is, as you guys can see, as it's growing out, it still looks really natural, and it doesn't have like a major line of demarcation. So I really like this technique because it grows out so beautifully, and your clients are gonna love you for it. All right, so for her highlights, I'm gonna be mixing up just 25 volume, and I'm gonna be using my Blondor from Wella. I'll do about just a little over a scoop for her because I do her hair a lot. I know exactly how much we usually mix up. So I'm gonna do 25, and of course I'm gonna add in some Olaplex as well. So then for her low light, I'm gonna do 15 volume with permanent color from Kenra. So I just do equal parts of 10 and 20. And the reason why I do 15 volume versus 20 or 10 is because I want there to be some gray coverage, but I don't wanna pull up too much warmth. And so that's why I like to do a 15 volume. And then I'm also gonna do our 8NA from Kenra. I really like this color on her. When it fades out, it still looks pretty neutral. And so that's why I really, really like it. So I'm gonna mix this up here, and we'll have this be our low light. Alright, so I always start my highlights kind of right in the back of the crown, and if you guys notice with my highlight method, I actually don't start sectioning, I don't section anything out, I just literally dive right into the hair. And another thing you'll notice is I actually foil backwards. So I always work off the client's natural part, and I kind of find where the apex is on their head and kind of start right about there. So here we go, we got her first section, and I do clip away this front section. And I'm gonna start with my first kind of highlight piece. Now I do wanna make sure that I'm getting both quadrants, on both sides of the client's part line. So I'm just gonna start with my first foil here. And you guys can see, I usually start with a low light, so you guys can see that we already have some of that previous low light formula in there. So I'm going to weave out this piece and grab my foil, and I'm going to lay my foil down and push the hair over it. So locking that foil into place. And then I'm gonna grab my low light formula right here. And once I've done applying it, just fold it back over and go on to my next section. So I'm gonna grab a little section, and this is going to be left out of the hair. And grabbing my clip from before, just kind of clip this down so I have a nice clean section to start with. And then I'll grab my next highlight piece here. And you guys can see, I actually kind of work with like more baby light type pieces, so they're a little bit smaller here. They're not like thick like regular highlights. So I'm just gonna weave this out. Grab my foil and just apply my lightener. Now one thing that you will notice me do is I do keep it a little bit off the root right here. I'm not going all the way down because we wanna make sure, especially these back foils, they are gonna be moved a little bit. So we just wanna be sure that we're not, you know, squishing them or having bleed marks or anything like that. fold my foil down and continue down. So I'm gonna probably do about 2 highlights to 1 low light. And I'll show you guys as we kind of work our way down. We're gonna stop right about here because we're only doing a partial on her today, and then we'll work forward. So I'm gonna do 1 last foil down here. So typically for a partial, this is about how far down I go, kind of right about where the head starts to kind of round back down. Again, every client's a little bit different. So for clients that have a lot of depth under here, she doesn't, because we always put kind of foils in there. We're not going to today, but we have in the past, so it's not too bad. But for some clients that have a lot of depth, I will sometimes put maybe just a few foils down here just to give them a little bit of dimension throughout the bottom. But again, it's always gonna depend on that client and depend on the placement. And sometimes when my clients come in, I'll throw a few foils underneath, like in the lower section down here, and next time I'll throw a few more so it evenly kind of gets a little bit of dimension underneath there, so it doesn't just have like a total like dark section down here. All right, so this is my last foil. And for a partial, I always just do it starting here and work my way down. If we were doing a full, I would start down here, work my way up, and then kind of meet this section. So I typically don't have these foils kind of going bending backwards, if that makes sense. We don't want to over direct them too much. Okay, so now that I finished this last foil, I'm going to just kind of grab the hair and fold that foil in half and bring all my hair down until we get to that top section. All right, so now that I finished folding back all of these foils, I will spin my client around and work forward. So I've spun my model all the way around, and as you guys remember, this was a low light, so I'm going to take my little piece, leave this out. This is our natural hair, and the reason why I like to leave some of the natural hair out is so that she doesn't have a solid line growing out, and again, that's what's really gonna help have that subtle grow out phase for her versus having a huge line of demarcation. So I'm going to weave this section and do the exact same thing. So lock my foil into place and grab my lightener, because this is going to be a highlight now. So I'm still doing about 2 to 1. Now I do vary my pattern. Occasionally I'll do every other, just to kind of break it up a tiny, tiny bit. But for the most part, I'm doing about 2 highlights to 1 low light. We'll fold that down. And then again, just kind of leave this little baby light section out and go on to the next one. So you guys can see these are very fine highlights. I'm not doing thick, chunky highlights. And the reason why, again, is we want this to grow out as naturally as possible. And so it's really, really important. The more fine you do your highlights while still packing a lot in there, will still give you that brightness the client wants, add the dimension, but without having it grow out really chunky or without it being like really big and chunky. So I'm just gonna keep moving down her entire part line till we get to the front, kind of finish up this mohawk section. And when we get to the front, I'll show you guys exactly what I'm doing. So now that I've gotten closer towards the hairline, you guys can see we're really close to the hairline here. I started to fold these foils back down. So after I folded them in half, I folded them in half again, just so when I'm clipping back these shorter hairs, I didn't have to reach them all the way back. So that's kind of an easier way to do it. And it also keeps the foils more locked in place. Now you guys can see with her, she's got this little cowlick piece right here, and we want to make sure that this is still getting touched, but not like chunky blonde. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my natural low light piece and let that hang out. And then I'm going to grab a highlight and we're going to weave this out here. And I want to make sure that I'm being really precise with this little section here, especially because she's got so many little baby hairs. So I do get really close, but I do love this brush from Framar because it allows me to, in case I got a little close, I can just kind of pull it up there with the tail comb. So I really like that brush. It allows me to be really precise and clean with my work. So that'll fold in half there. And then again, we're leaving out just another little baby light piece. And these little baby lights around the hair, look at this. She's got hardly any little hair here, but we still wanna make sure that we're adding foils in here. And this is what's gonna set you apart from other stylists in your area by doing these little face framing baby lights, because these are almost mimicking the gray that she has growing out naturally. So we're just barely touching them, right? You guys can see there's hardly any hair in that foil. But by doing this, this is really gonna set you apart from other stylists, and it's gonna help it grow out really nicely. So this little piece right around her hairline, I think is good to leave out because she has enough gray growing in there, so I don't think we need to highlight it. But when we come around here to the side, we are gonna make sure to get these little guys. All right, so now that we've gotten to these little sections right here on the side, I wanna make sure that I am getting these. So I just do a kind of just slice and just kind of weave out a little bit. Now, I like to use a regular size foil for these, but you could totally tear your foil in half and do a smaller foil here. Totally up to you and what works for your clients, but sometimes clients that have really fine hair, it does help having a smaller foil. Okay, so I'm just gonna kind of barely pull this little guy through. And then clip this guy out of the way. And I'm gonna do another one of these. Now, these I usually like to do highlights instead of highlight low light. And the reason why is because we are trying to mimic her natural gray color coming in. So a low light wouldn't necessarily mimic that, and it actually might cause a warm spot just because it is permanent color right around the scalp. So I personally like to do highlights for these. Barely kind of tap that in there. And that's why sometimes having a smaller foil does help, just to get it in there a little bit easier for you. All right, so now that we've kind of clipped those up, I'm going to do her hairline pieces here. We'll clip that away just while we're working here. All right, so these are just gonna be my little highlights around the face. Now this isn't super, super baby fine. You could go more fine, but usually for her, this works really well. But again, it's all gonna depend on your client, what their hairline looks like. You guys know I say that in pretty much any one of my videos. So just figure out what works best for you and your clients. Gonna barely touch my lightener in there because she doesn't have very many roots. And fold this up right here. Now you guys can see that I overfolded my foil. Sometimes that happens. I didn't mean to do that on purpose. All I'm gonna do is just kind of barely fold that back like that. And now I'm actually gonna do a low light right here for a highlight for our next one. So two highlights, and then I'll do one low light. This one is a little bit more of a baby fine one. I typically, depending on the client, like to do two highlights and then a low light, just to give it some depth right there too, so you don't have just like total blonde chunk, but I usually like to do two baby lights or two highlights first. And then this last little low light piece. And you guys can see these are the patterns that we've already done on her hair before. But you guys can see there's a little bit of that gray coming in, and that's why it is nice to have this low light that fits really nicely, but it's also blending that gray. And you guys will notice when I am adding my low light color, I do pull the color all the way through. Some people leave out the ends. Personally, for me, I just like to refresh the color, especially on her because it's only a level 8. I don't really feel too bad about pulling color all the way through. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to do diagonal backs all the way through to the side till we get around to this corner, and I'll show you guys the other side too. All right, so now we got to the other side of her head, and this is the side where she has a little bit less hair, and kind of, if you guys remember, she had that calotte kind of right here, close to this side. So instead of just doing this corner piece right here, I'm actually going to take this first foil, and you guys can see it kind of almost like arches the way that I had done the foils, and I still want to capture some of these little baby hairs. So I'm gonna take my first foil just really, really lightly right here. And I think, again, this is kind of comes back to, I don't always have the exact foil placement for every single client. Now I work off a similar pattern, but every client's gonna be just a little bit different. And so I kind of customize it for every client. And every time, even their appointments could be a little bit different depending on how I place the foils. So just something to note that it's not always an exact cut and clear type thing. So we're gonna pull this foil up right here, and now I can kind of go into that corner, but I still will leave a little bit of that natural low light out is what I'm calling it. Do this next piece, because again, we don't want this to be like a blonde chunk right here, so. And if you guys are ever concerned about these little pieces in the front, when in doubt, go thinner than you think. If you're worried about them being chunky or too blonde or whatever, just go thinner. And it always works out in the best way when you do a more thin foil. It's always gonna blend better. It's always gonna just lay really nicely. So if you're ever concerned about there being like a line right here, just do it nice and thin. Now we'll do one more kind of right just about here. So I'll take that natural low light, leave this out. I'm gonna do one more blonde one right here. And this is just kind of getting her widow's peak area. Most clients have that. And what I see a lot of hairstylists do is they do just the front hairline right here in the front and then the sides, and they miss this little peak area. And so when the client wears their hair back, they have what I call like a valley of darkness right there. We don't want that. No client wants that. They want to see brightness all the way through around their hair. So make sure to include this little section. It's really important. I didn't used to when I was first starting out because I was never taught to. And when I started to realize my clients had this like chunk of dark right there, I realized that, oh, I need to just add some foils there. So that's what I started doing, and it made the biggest difference. All right, so now we're gonna move around to her hairline right here. Should do a little bit thicker of a foil here. It doesn't need to be quite as thin. But I still will always weave it out. So you guys can see there's not a ton of hairs in this foil, and this is important to keep it really blended. And again, your clients will notice this stuff, especially when they've gone to a stylist before that maybe has left them with like blonde chunks around their face. These are the details that clients notice when it comes to highlights. When your blondes become picky about that stuff, that's a good thing. You actually want them to be a little picky about it because you can bring them that service of the high quality blonde around their face and not have these chunks of blonde. All right, so we're sticking with our two highlights to one low light. Now this little piece is gonna hang out here. I'm just gonna let that be our natural low light there versus trying to get it in a foil. I think that that's fine. We do wanna have some natural coming through too. You guys can see this piece kind of got a little bit tight in there with our lightener, so I'm just gonna kind of take my brush and pull that through. If you needed to, you could even take a towel or just even your finger and pull that through so that doesn't add a bleed mark there, because that's the last thing we want is a bleed mark right around the hairline. And now we're gonna do our low light. And I'm just gonna keep continuing back all the way, doing diagonal back sections until we reach this little corner. We did basically our sectioning was this mohawk all the way down till kind of about where the head starts to round out. We left it kind of stopped right there for our partial, and then we did these smaller little pieces right here to cover those alleyways, and then from around the hairline we basically just did diagonal backs all the way up until we reached about this point right here. So with most of them I did about two highlights to one low light, except for around the face where I did two highlights. Same thing here, I did about three highlights here in the top, and then these guys were mostly highlights, no low lights there. So just as a recap, that's pretty much our sectioning and what we did. It's almost like the basic highlight pattern, but I wanted to show you guys little ways that you can tweak it and make it your own. So I rinsed her, I shampooed her out, and I put on the Biolage Raw Acidic Care Color Care Milk Rinse just over her hair. We're actually not gonna do a conditioner because this actually almost works as a conditioner for us. And one thing that I wanna make note of is I don't do any toners on her because her highlights lift out really naturally and the low lights blend really easily. She doesn't need a toner, she doesn't need a base bump. It's a really simple application where it's just your highlights and low lights and then rinse it out. So we're gonna rinse her, get her going, and I'll show you guys the results. And here is our final results. You guys can see how beautiful it looks, so shiny, so healthy, but look how blended it is. That gray is blended in there so nicely, and her low lights just add so much dimension without adding too much depth or darkness. They just blend really well. It actually kind of warms up her hair a little bit too, instead of having it be so gray and ashy. I love how this turned out. You guys can see how it blends right around the hairline so beautifully, and just looks so good. So I hope you guys try this out.
All right guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope you picked up something new that you can use in the salon all the time. I'm all about creating really easy techniques that are easy to use and that are used in the salon a lot. So I'm not about creating those crazy techniques that you'll never use. This is a technique that you can use all the time, and I really hope you try it. So before I go, I hope that you guys actually try foiling backwards. And if you are somebody who foils forwards or backwards, let me know in the comments below which way you foil, and if you're gonna try foiling backwards the way that I foil. And as always, make sure to hit the subscribe button below and turn on the little bell down there, because when you click on that bell, what it's gonna do is every time I post a brand new video, you're gonna be notified of when I post a new video, so you're gonna be some of the first people to see it and comment it and like it, right? To Instagram and say hi. Let me know what you liked about this video, if you learned something, and like I said, if you're gonna try that backwards foiling technique. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time.